Let's start by putting things into context. I'm a big fan of Doom. It ran well, looked pretty for the time, and more importantly, had tens of thousands of third-party maps available for it. The level structure was relatively easy to learn, and it opened the door for the masses to build deathmatch arenas based on their house or their place of work. Everyone and their dog was therefore looking forward to the next generation game in the form of Quake. It promised even better modding without a single hard-coded value and real-time dynamic world editing. Unfortunately, it didn't exactly deliver on these promises. Though interestingly, Duke 3D did deliver some of the promises that Quake didn't. As for the game itself, it just didn't have that vital spark. Coming from the shiny Technicolor world of Doom to a drab, blocky world where everything was cow shit pile brown, as H.R. Giger might put it, was arguably more realistic, but it didn't make the game look terribly attractive. Looks are one thing, but the gameplay was just the same as Doom, only a little bit worse. The fact that you had no hands and are forced to push buttons with your face didn't help matters either. Analyzing the data files and finding the death messages did provide one glimmer of hope. Satan's power deflects player name's telefrag. Holy shit! We get to fight Satan himself! That was enough to convince me to play the full game all the way through, just to see the final confrontation between good and evil. Incidentally, the Psychedelic Years Volume 3 worked quite well as a soundtrack to the game. Fighting the hordes of evil while Jefferson Airplane ranted eerily about the end of the world is an experience I'd love to share, but can't for copyright reasons. So, I valiantly fought my way through Quake in 2 days flat, slogging my way through a game which frankly wasn't any fun. Just to confront Satan. Yes, Satan! One last look in the devil's red eyes. And here we are, the final confrontation with a sea anemone. Are you kidding? I, a student, paid £30 to confront a polyp, which doesn't even fight back and just sits there waving its fronds. Are you mental? Okay, so that didn't help matters. Fortunately, like Ultima 9, we get the most fun by breaking the game. Let's consider the cheat mode, for instance. One of Quake's great innovations was the command console, something which even Skyrim has, and will probably be in the next Elder Scrolls game too, if it ever ships. To give yourself goodies, you use the give command. This wasn't documented, so trying to figure things out got a little interesting. Giving H, that is, heroin, will reduce the Quake Marine to a drooling mess lying on his side, unable to move like a spice zombie. Interestingly, he is still able to jump, despite being sideways. It took a considerable time to realize that Give H is actually setting the player's health, and because we didn't specify a number, A2I interpreted it as zero, thus leaving the player in a weird limbo state of clinical death where he's no longer technically alive, but he hasn't actually died either. Giving him more H will duly restore him to life. Similarly, the game is willing to hand out all kinds of narcotics without complaint. One of the staples of Quake is the lightning gun. If we fire it underwater, it will do an obscene amount of damage to you and everything else in the vicinity. It's good for fishing if you can survive, which generally requires God mode. As is not uncommon, Quake implements lava as boiling orangeade, so firing the lightning gun while in the lava will also do an obscene amount of damage. Where this gets really fun is that the lightning gun's short circuit will also destroy anyone in direct contact with you. Assuming you have God mode to cushion the blow, anyone who touches you while doing this will explode instead. This includes dimensional shamblers, who also have a lightning attack. Because the lightning is an actual solid object projecting out of them instead of a video effect, The damage will travel back up it, obliterating them. So that's Quake. I can't help but feel a bit disappointed, even nearly 25 years later. But them's the breaks. Some you win, some you lose, and for me, Quake wasn't a win.